welcome to episode 22 of the Reading Coves podcast. If you're a book lover who may be interested in joining our online book club, please visit our website at thereadingcove.com. For September 2012, we're discussing Night Road by Kristin Hannah. But the rest of the story I really enjoyed. I thought it was pretty interesting. What did you guys think about Jude?
She bothered me like the entire book. I mean, just from the beginning when she walked her daughter into school, and I'm thinking, okay, you're worried about your child being made fun of, and you're going to walk her up to into the school that's social suicide right there. And she asked you not to do that. She told you the kids will make fun of me if you do that. And she was like, didn't care. Just didn't even acknowledge her daughter's feelings at all. She's going to do what she wants to do. She doesn't take her kids' feelings into account.
Some teenagers get killed, you know, during drunk driving. They have, they usually like right around the graduation time. We live right down the road from this high school, and they'll bring out one of those bashed up cars that, you know, that was from someone getting killed from a warning. So.
And what did you guys think about the actual incident, the accident that happened? And where the turn the story took from there.
To me, it was like getting hit with cold water. I mean, you're just kind of enjoying the story, and then all of a sudden,
boom,
everything goes bad. Me is dead. Lexi's going to prison. It's just,
I thought the courtroom scene with that was interesting. I was like, wow, my God. And you speak about Miles, and I said this in the group before, but I really felt like his character didn't even need to, he wasn't even necessary. He felt like a household prop.
Yeah,
like,
he was just there. He was just the dad, you know.
He was just mentioned, and it's like, why even bother saying they have a dad? Because he really didn't play much of a role at all.
I know, because it seemed like the Zach and Mia counted more on their mom and went to her with more things. Granted, you know, he was a doctor, and I'm sure he had long hours, and he wasn't as readily available to them. But still, at the same time, it seemed like the mom just ran everything, and he was just there for special functions or whatever.
I liked it. I know it's kind of a mixed feeling book. I think she made some good points and kind of wanted to give others something to think about.
Right.
That's what I did. I'm thinking, wow, I really need to think about when my kids get to the age when they're starting to go to parties and driving and, you know, how I'm going to handle punishing them so they actually do call for a ride. So it's kind of like...
And like you said, it's pretty mixed in the group. Marianne didn't like it very much, and she was saying she thought it was written in a very manipulative way, trying to pull emotions or manipulate the reader's emotions. And of course, then we have a lot of other people who disagree and who loved it and who said, you know, they teared up reading it. I don't remember tearing up, but I do remember...